Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a trailblazing comedian and an Academy Award nominee, but he never takes himself too seriously.
Please welcome down to the circle, Sampson McCormick.
Yay!
Look at you.
Welcome.
Hey, Sam. Hey.
Have a seat. Purple marks your spot.
Thank you.
Yes.
Oh, my God. It's so good to be here. And Atlanta is one of my favorite cities.
Really?
Yeah, it's the land of the diva. Because yes. I came through the airport. I mean, at the airport, you see it.
Oh, they be so sharp.
Oh, yeah. The weaves and the lace fronts and the high heels.
Oh, you tried it?
And the makeup and stuff. And that's just the fellas.
Yes.
The
girls say
okay.
Listen, you are the first openly gay comedian.
Well, not the first, but okay. I was definitely one of the first black gay ones, too.
Okay, okay.
And thank y'all for giving me the space to come on, because a lot of, you know, different shows and things don't give a platform to LGBT artists.
Well, thank you for living your truth and being your best self. Yes. And we love that down to the circle.
Thank you.
And speaking of acceptance, do you feel that there's more acceptance in comedy with the LGBTQ community?
As long as Fuck You Deneva is not doing it.
Right.
No, I'm just playing. I'm teasing. No, the thing is this, is something happened where internet comedy began being taken more seriously than actual live stand-up comedy.
Oh.
So on the internet, people see wigs and things like that. And I don't show up like that. I just show up as a regular dude, you know, regular Southern dude, and I talk about our issues.
Mm-hmm.
And I try to be relatable. I take pride in the fact that I can stand on the stage and make, you know, straight black dudes, my straight brothers laugh.
Right. Yeah. And as a stand-up comedian, too, I also can relate to that. Internet versus stand-up on the stage, there is definitely a difference. How have you been able to fight through that, though?
Just showing up and being hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and sticking to it. I mean, we come from such a fabric. And black people, we're funny as I don't know what.
Yes, we are.
I mean, you go down to the cookout or the church or whatever.
Just anyway.
And make
them
laugh, right.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the things that we've come from and we've made humor out of, it's beautiful. And that's the fabric that we're cut from.
You're known for doing material about growing up gay in the South.
Yes.
How did your family react to that?
Well, it wasn't the family. It was the church.
Come on now.
Okay, because the thing is, the black church needs to get over the issue of sexuality. Because, you know, they used to tell me all the time, we don't want homosexuals in the church.
And I'm like, they're there.
Yeah, I'm like, so if you kick all the gay people out of the church, who's going to sing in the choir?
Who's going to sing in the choir?
Okay.
And write the music.
And write the music.
And sometimes preach the sermon.
Preach the sermon. You know, we're there. You know, we've always been a part of the community since we got here off the boat. We've been a part of the community. We need to get over that.
Now, let me ask you something. Have you ever found yourself in a bit of a kerfuffle or a pickle?
Yes, I did.
Based on your material.
Yeah, like again, the church is always, and I mean, we need to get over it. Jesus loves everybody.
Yes,
I don't care. You know, like Jesus sees some of these folks in the dark. At least I do what I do in the light. Hello.
Hello, somebody.
And the light hits me bright.
Hello.
And so it's that, and I did a show recently, and the Ku Klux Klan came out to my show.
Ooh,
they came
really?
Out. I didn't even know they
to
liked
say
comedy.
What?
No, they came out, and they were just, I mean, now we live in the age of Trump. So,
right.
You know, like people are coming out. And I was in Traverse City, Michigan, and they came out, and they didn't want to see the F word, you know, F-A-G word, and they didn't want to see a black person up there. It was too much for them.
Did they introduce themselves and say, I'm the Ku Klux Klan? How did you know?
Yeah, like
that show up and
shit.
Well, they don't wear the outfits anymore. They show up dressed like they work at the Apple store now.
Oh.
You know,
police officer outfits.
Yeah, police officer outfits,
now.
All
Hello.
That type of stuff. And they came and they had like a Confederate flag. They had signage and everything.
Wow.
And so security, she comes back, because I was definitely one of the only black people in the town.
Okay.
Me and my shadow. And she came back there and she said, you know, we got a bit of a pickle.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I'm like, what's going on?
Right.
And she said, you got protesters. I've had protesters before.
Yeah, of course.
You haven't had protesters until you've had black Baptists throwing oil on you after a show.
Come on now.
Okay.
Oh,
so I was like, let whoever it is in. She said, it's the Klan. And I'm like confused because it was 2017. And I was like, you mean like the Wu-Tang Clan? You know, I was, okay. Like you know, and she was like, no, this is the Ku Klux Klan. And the audience is going bananas. And I said, this is a time, because if there's one thing that I've learned being a black gay man, it's how to show other people love when they don't deserve it, because I haven't gotten it when I do deserve
it. Come on, man.
So, that's how you teach it.
Absolutely. That's how you teach them. So I went out there and I had to calm them down.
Right.
And they ended up staying for the show.
Of course they did, because you're funny. Mm-hmm. Let me say this. Congratulations on your Oscar nomination. You were in a movie called I Live Here.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about the film real quickly. And also, do you have more film projects coming?
Yes. And I'm always going to do stand-up, but I've been doing stand-up almost 20 years.
Okay.
So it's sometimes you just got to shift gears and start doing something else.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm always, I mean, it's here, you know, it's there. So I Live Here was directed by Shane Watson, and it's an independent film. It was nominated in the domestic narrative category last year. And so when he called and said it, I was like, what? You know, and we partied pretty hard.
Nice.
Yeah, and I have another film that'll be out this summer. That deals with just issues with parents and family.
Okay. Nice. Yes.
Tell us about your experience with Robin Williams coming to your show.
Yes. So I did a show about a year before he passed away, and he came
wow.
backstage to the show, and you know, he was like, "I want to watch," and I'm not going to tell him no.
Right.
And it was huge, and you know, so when I found out he passed, it was a bit of a shock because he was an amazing dude.
Yes, he was.
Well, yeah. Sampson, mm-hmm. we are so honored that you came down here, and so blessed and privileged to have you here down to the circle.
Come
and you
on,
are welcome to come at any time. And for more information on Sampson, follow us at Sister Circle TV on all social networks.